You walked into the room and now my heart's been stolen. You took me back in time to when I was unbroken. And now you're all I want, and I knew it from the very first moment. 'Cause a light came on when I heard that song, and I want you to sing it again. I swear that every word you sing, you wrote them for me, like it was a private show, but I know you never saw me. When the lights come on and I'm on my own, will you be there? Sing it again. Could I be the one you talk about in all your stories? Can I be him? Can I be him? I heard there was someone, but I know he don't deserve you. And if you were mine, I'd never let anyone hurt you. I wanna dry those tears, kiss those lips, it's all I've been thinking about. 'Cause the light came on when I heard that song, and I want you to sing it again. I swear that every word you sang, you wrote them for me, like it was a private show, but I know you never saw me. When the lights come on and I'm on my own, will you be there to sing it again? Could I be the one you talk about in all your stories? Can I be the one? Can I be the one? Oh, can I be him? Won't you sing it again? Oh, when you sing it again, can I be him? Or sing it again? Oh, when you sing it again, can I be him? 'Cause I swear that every word you sang, you wrote it for me. Oh, like it was a private show, but I know you never saw me. Oh, when the lights come on and I'm on my own, will you be there? Will you be there? Could I be the one you talk about in all your stories? Can I be him? Ooh, can I be him? Can I be him? Or can I be him?
Lying in my bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you. Caught up in circles, confusion is nothing new. Flashback, warm nights almost left behind. Suitcase of memories, time after. Sometimes you picture me, I'm walking too far ahead. You're calling to me, I can't hear what you've said. Then you say, go slow, I fall behind. The second hand unwinds. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time, if you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time, after my picture fades and darkness has turned to gray, watching through windows, you're wondering if I'm okay. Secrets stolen from deep inside, the drum beats out of time. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time, if you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time, oh, if you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time, oh, if you fall, I will catch you, I will be waiting. Time after time, ah, time after time.
Today is almost perfect, but we knew that was never going to be, but it's as perfect as it can be. And I say that because it's missing someone very special to us, someone who loved and was loved by so many of us here today, the most important person in Fiona and her mum's Pauline's life, and someone who became one of the most important in mine too, and that's Fiona's dad, John. John was a great man, the greatest in every sense, and one of the greatest I will ever know, and we miss him. Few men like me are lucky to have not one, but two father figures in their lives, and today I am proud and honoured to finally call John my father-in-law. But even before that, he was my friend. I once thought the 5 years we got getting to know each other for anyone or anything, because they were the five of the best years of my life. As this is the only chance I'll ever get, I've often thought about how I can tell you what John meant to me, ever since I asked what was for both of us the most important question I could. And that was for his blessing in taking his beautiful daughter's hand in marriage. Even though at first he jokingly said no. But I always imagined John being sat next to me whilst I did it. But then I imagined he was far too humble to let me say any of this. The best way I can is that he was like a superhero, a real life Superman. Someone who I worshipped and I was in awe of. He made the impossible possible and put those that he loved above all else. Just when I thought I knew it all, I met John and he really taught me it all. If one day our children, not yet, there's no big announcement, ask me what their granddad was like or who he was, I may say he was only slightly better at DIY than me. And he just edged it out on the golf course or on the pool table. But then I would be lying, and in reality I won't need to say a word, because all I would need to do is point to their mum to show them. Fiona, every day you remind me of your dad, and remind me of everything that was perfect in him and everything that's perfect in your mum. You have their incredible courage, bravery, strength, and an extraordinary habit of never letting anyone down, ever, no matter what. Your dad was, and will be so proud of everything you have become, and I want to thank you for bringing him and your mum into my life, and allowing us to share a bond that will never be broken, and only the three of us will ever understand. That's an unconditional love for you that nobody can equal. And that brings me to the most important reason why I am in favour of weddings, and family, and friendship and love, and everything that comes with it, and why we get married, and certainly why I am getting married, and that reason is you. Fiona, my wife, my breathtakingly beautiful wife, What did I do to deserve you? I've already been told I'm punching already today. Twice. You look stunning. And I hope that today and every day, you know how amazing you are. Because I certainly do. I've lived out today in my head for the last 8 years. Not for the hope that it might prepare me for how I might feel or what I might say when I saw you down the aisle. Because it goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway, that I knew nothing ever would. Because when you find the person that you've always been looking for, that person that you want to spend the rest of your life with, you want the rest of your life to start as soon as possible. And Fiona, my life started when I met you. You give me purpose and you help me realise every reason, every hope and every dream I ever have. Your smile brightens my darkest hours. I love you not only for what you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you not only for what you've made of yourself, but also for what you're making of me. From late nights, or rather early mornings, in the university library, to jobs, dogs, and renovating our first home together with your dad, we've built our lives together from the ground up, brick by brick. You can learn a lot about a person in 8 years and become as much a part of them as another person can. You learn how they let their palm tickled until they fall asleep. And then you also learn that they wake up in the middle of the night screaming. because they think a polar bear is in the room. You learn how they like to steal your socks and stretch them, how you share a love for food that can never be satisfied, particularly burgers. And you learn how they like to pause the TV every 5 minutes to ask what's going on. You learn how they like to dawdle and take 10 minutes to leave the house. And you learn how they're both completely resigned to the fact that you will never be the most loved in the house, because that will always be our dog, Buddy. You also learn that you share some of the best memories, like dancing on the beach in Cuba until the early hours without a care in the world, not regretting it one bit the next day, despite the hangover. Or scouring every street in Rome, on foot, with a ring, hidden in your spare socks in your backpack, looking for a quiet, romantic spot to propose, before finally admitting defeat, because it's Rome and nowhere is quiet, and retreating to the well-known Roman landmark of the Desio Home Hotel to propose. What I'm trying to say is that you learn that you don't marry someone you live with, you marry someone you can't live without. And that sums us up perfectly. Because you learn how it doesn't matter where you are, as long as you are together. Fiona, whether all of that will be enough to carry us through it all, carry all that life will throw at us, I don't know. I honestly don't know. But one thing I do know is that I'm as sure as a man can possibly be when I said the words I do. So when you're hurting, let me take the pain. When things aren't going to plan, let me help you find your smile. When you're scared, I will protect you. And I'll do all that, the heart bursting with love. You're the bravest, strongest and smartest person I know. Braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. The purest and most selfless person I will ever meet. And whether they are friend or family, your loyalty and love is unconditional. You cry when you're happy, and you smile when you're afraid. And I owe you so much, because you've taught me so much. You're my best friend, my motivation, my inspiration, my everything really. And you know me better than I know myself. So, in front of all of our family and friends, I thought I would keep this next part simple. Walking with your hands in mine and mine in yours, that's exactly where I want to be, always. Right beside you is where I belong from this moment on. I love you until the very end. So, can I now ask that you all please stand one last time for our final toast? And raise your glass to the roof to family, friends, and of course to my beautiful wife, Mrs. Fiona Jane Fields. Yeah. Cheers.
I know I like to have a joke with you and pull your leg on a lot of things, but I wouldn't be the person I am today without you. You have always been my role model in life and continuously inspire me. Over the years, you've shown me, Sophie and Alice, what it's like to have an amazing brother.
I know, yeah.
And I want you to know that being your younger brother will always be one of the greatest highlights of my life. So if you'd all join me for one last toast to the happy married couple, Daniel and Fiona.
Don't know much about history, don't know much biology, don't know much about a science book. Don't know much about the French I took, but I do know that.
much trigonometry. Don't know much about algebra. Don't know what a sliding rule is for. But I do know what it was to. And if this one could be with you, what a wonderful world this would be. Now, I don't claim to be an A student, but I'm trying to be. For maybe by being an A student, baby, I can win your love for me. Don't know much about history. Don't know much biology. Don't know much about a science book. Don't know much about the French I took. But I do know that I love you.